Yes, Ayush, are you there in the classroom? Yes, okay. Sum of exteriors of any polygon.
Yeah, ma'am. Sorry, ma'am.
Okay. Exteriors of any polygon. Exterior angles. What is sum of exterior angles of any polygon, children?
360, ma'am.
Very good. Polygon is 360 degrees. So what is sum of interiors, Nana?
180, ma'am.
Kaadu, Nana. Interiors of a polygon. Formula chepte chaalu, Nana, naaku.
180?
N minus 2 into?
180, ma'am.
Ah, yes. Don't forget, children. N minus 2 into 180. These are the important things. Suppose if you want to find out, yes, each side of your polygon or each angle of your polygon, how you supposed to find out each angle of your polygon, each angle in your regular polygon, each angle in your regular polygon, how to find each angle in your regular polygon, Nana?
N minus 3 by 2, ma'am.
Each angle in regular polygon. Regular polygon. What are angles? What are the sum of, how many diagonals also? Diagonals you are telling. Now, just now, what you are telling? Diagonals of your polygon you are telling. Diagonals of polygon. What are diagonals of polygon, Nana?
360 by the number of sides.
Diagonals, Nana. Just now you said that is the formula.
N minus 3
n
by
into,
N into N minus 3 by 2, ma'am.
Yes. So suppose where N is number of sides. Number of sides of a polygon. Suppose 10-sided polygon is there. How many diagonals we can make a 10-sided polygon, children? 10 into 10 minus 3. How much 10 minus 3 means?
7
by
2.
2. So this is nothing but 5. This is 5 into 7. It's 35 diagonals we can make for the 10-sided polygon. Yes, children, this is the way you can find out the number of diagonals, number of sum of interiors. Each angle in a regular polygon, you can divide with, what is n-sided polygon? How you will find the sum of angles in n-sided polygon? Yes? Yes, Nana. How you will find, suppose 5 sides are there, how many, what is the angle, sum of interiors in that?
540 by 5.
Yes, 540 by 5. Yes, how you will get this 540? Suppose how we can take that?
N minus 2 by 180.
Very good. N minus 2 by?
180.
N minus 2 by 180. No, it's not by 180.
Into 180.
Yes, into 180 divided by N.
The number of sides.
Yes. Number of sides. If you divide with that, you will get a number of angles, each angle in a regular polygon. That is also formula based. You can remember, children. No need to remember also. We know that sum of angles interior is n minus 2 into 180. You just divide with number of sides so that you will get each angle of a regular polygon. Next.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Harshita.
Yes, ma'am, can you share the, in resources, can you share the recording of previous class, ma'am?
It is already there, ma'am. In resources, it is already there.
It's not there, ma'am. I just checked.
No, it is there. Let me show just now. I will show with you. It's, what is the class? Which class it is? 8B, right? 8B. Resources. Class recordings. See, everything is uploaded. Up to date, it is happening. Till 14th, it is uploaded, everything. 15th, you have examination, no class. 15th yesterday I didn't have class, so today I am teaching, automatically it will be uploaded.
Okay. Yes, ma'am. Now I can see. Thank you.
Yeah, because you can refresh and go, no, ma'am.
Yeah, ma'am.
You can refresh every time and go, because that loaded will happen. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Next, children, some special parallelograms we have. What are parallelograms? We know that. What is a parallelogram, children? Not only parallelogram, we have to study different types of polygons first, children. What are different quadrilaterals? We can take a square, rectangle. Yes or no? You learned what are the four-sided polygons, Nana?
Quadrilateral, ma'am.
Yes, quadrilateral, four-sided polygon. In this, there are what are four-sided polygon? We have just let me draw a few diagrams so that you can which shape it is, children.
Parallelogram.
Yes, what is this? How many sides you have here?
Four.
Four-sided polygon. Is it a quadrilateral?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
How many diagonals we can draw for this parallelogram, children? What are the properties you're supposed to learn for the parallelogram, children? What are the properties you can write here? Parallelogram is a quadrilateral with each pair of opposite sides are parallel. What are the sides are parallel, Nana? Opposite sides are parallel. Parallelogram, you have to write. Each pair of opposite sides are parallel. Not only that, you can take with opposite sides are equal. Opposite sides, if you take this and this are equal, these two opposite sides are equal. You can write all the points, children. Opposite sides are equal. Opposite sides are equal for parallelogram. Opposite sides are parallel to equal and parallel. Opposite sides are equal and parallel. Parallel means, what is the meaning for parallel, children?
They do not meet at any point.
Yes, they never meet at any point. If you extend at any place, any part, they never meet. Diagonals bisect one another. 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 Each pair of opposite sides are parallel. Each pair of opposite sides are parallel. Yes or no, children? If you're supposed to take A, B, C, D is a parallelogram, what are the sides parallel to each other? AB is parallel to CD. Yes. What is another pair here? What is another pair we can write? Even AD is parallel
AD is parallel to CB.
BC or C? Yeah. CB. If you take from down, you can take from the same procedure. Yes. Same order. Can we go with other shape like a rhombus? A rhombus, how it looks, children? How it looks, rhombus?
I'm like a diamond.
Yes, like a diamond. What are the properties of rhombus? What is the difference between square and rhombus?
All sides are equal in a rhombus too.
Even square also, all sides are equal, right, Nana?
Yes, ma'am.
What is the difference between square and rhombus? Anyone from the class? Ayush? Ayush, are you there, Nana?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, what is the difference between square and rhombus, Ayush?
Ma'am, square has...
Ma'am, rhombus, right? Is a quadrilateral.
Yes, even square is also a quadrilateral, right? Yes or no, Bhavya?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, so what is the difference between rhombus and...
Ma'am, I think the angle.
Very good. And one more point also you can say. All sides are equal for rhombus. What you said as a square, all sides are equal for this. Any other points, children?
Opposite angles are equal.
Very good. Opposite angles are equal. What is opposite angles here? Diagonals are perpendicular to each other, Nana. But if you take a square, diagonals are bisect each other. But in this case, the diagonals are
perpendicular.
What are diagonals? We know that how to draw diagonals too. Diagonals are perpendicular to rhombus. Diagonals are perpendicular to each other. All properties same, like opposite sides are equal and parallel. Here also you can write it as all sides are equal. No, no. All sides are equal. All sides are equal length. All sides are equal. All sides are equal. Diagonals bisect each other. Diagonals bisect each other and diagonals are perpendicular to each other. Bisect means what, children? Bisecting means what?
They meet at a point.
Yes, so this part, whatever the part from O to, suppose if I'm taking as A, B, C, D is a rhombus. So in this, the point, midpoint is O. Bisect means what? AO is nothing but? AO is nothing but OC. Yes or no? And DO is nothing but OB. That means they are bisecting each other, means dividing into two equal parts. Yes, ma? All sides are equal. Diagonals are perpendicular to each other. Diagonals are perpendicular to each other. Based on this property, we can do many bits. Nana, diagonals are perpendicular to each other. Each other means, if suppose whatever the, let me write on that. OA is nothing but, OA is nothing but OC. And OD is nothing but, OD is nothing but OB. Why? Because the diagonals are perpendicular. Perpendicular means what, Nana?
90 degrees.
Making 90 degrees and equal, they divide equally. Making 90 degrees, right. Next one, rectangle. What is difference between rectangle and parallelogram, children? What is difference between rectangle and parallelogram?
The angles are not equal.
Opposite angles are equal in parallelogram. Even in rectangle, opposite angles are equal. Yes or no?
No, ma'am. All are 90.
No, opposite sides are equal.
Yes.
Opposite sides are equal. Suppose this is length, if you take both the opposite sides are equal for rectangle. All angles interiors are 90. Very good point. You said all points, all angles are 90. Next, any other things we can write over here? Can we take it as a parallelogram with a special, with a right angle? Is a parallelogram with a right angle? Parallelogram with a right angle?
No, ma'am.
Yes, rectangle is a parallelogram with right angle, right? So then opposite sides are equal. Opposite sides are parallel. Yes or no? In this case also, opposite sides are parallel to each other. Rectangle.
Yes, ma'am.
But only the thing, parallelogram with 90 degrees. So we can write it as a rectangle. Very good. Yes, all properties, what you have for parallelogram, same thing applied. And each angle is at 90 degrees. Now, this is a very important point you're supposed to remember. Each angle is right angle. Each of the angle is right angle. Right, each of angle is 90 degrees. Next, diagonals are equal in this rectangle, Mama. That is one more important point. Diagonals are equal. Whatever the length happening for this, both diagonals are equal. Very, very important point, children. Diagonals are equal. All properties will be satisfied for the rectangle, whatever the parallelogram properties are happen. So only the thing, in this angles are different, that angles are parallelogram, there is no 90 angle. Here we have seen as 90 angle, each angle is 90. In this case, diagonals are equal. Diagonals are equal. Previous, whatever parallelogram, diagonals bisect one another. It's not equal. They will bisect one another. They will bisect one another. But here, rectangle diagonals are equal. That is the major differences you have to remember. Coming to the square. Can we take it as square as a special rhombus square? Excellent square. How we supposed to define square? How you supposed to define children? Shall we take it as all sides are equal, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Come on, children. Please take as all sides are equal. Yeah. If you take all sides are equal, all sides. You just mention all sides are equal in square, and all angles also equal, right, Nana? What are the angles? 90. These diagonals are also equal, Nana? Yes or no? Yes, what we can write here, children, about a square? Yes, all sides are equal. All sides are equal. Diagonals bisect each other. Write down all sides are equal. All sides are equal. Based on this, we are doing many properties. Bhavya.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, in rectangle, the diagonals also bisect, right, ma'am?
But equal diagonals are not bisect. Yes, bisect means making 90 is not possible in diagonal side, Nana. Bisect means it is not 90. You just see here, the angle should not be equal to 90 here. Is it 90? Then interiors, whatever the corner angles, maybe it is sum of interior angles, so maybe equal to 90. But it is diagonals are equal, it's not bisecting, Nana. That is the difference between. Okay, you understand what is my point?
Yes, ma'am.
They are equal, not bisect. They are not a bisecting. They are equal. They are not perpendicular bisectors. Next, all properties of parallelogram, whatever the properties of parallelogram, yes, all sides are equal. Yes, diagonals bisect each other. Diagonals bisect each other. In this case, diagonals bisect each other. Exactly whatever the portion is there, same thing, it is same. Here also diagonals are bisect each other. And diagonals are equal, diagonals bisect each other. Both points you can write now. Diagonals are equal.
Ma'am?
Yes, bisect.
Ma'am, so diagonals are perpendicular and diagonals bisect each other are the same, ma'am?
Perpendicular means 90, Nana. Bisect also, it is very similar. Perpendicular means only we are taking as, suppose the scene, Nana. There is a question. My question is, this is the question. Here, these two lines are not bisecting, but they are making, they are perpendicular. Suppose these two lines are bisecting and making bisecting each other. Bisecting means, Nana, equally divide two portions. But in this figure, this line is not equally divided, but making 90 degrees. But it is not dividing equally, right?
Yes, ma'am.
You understand the difference between what is, even though it is forming 90, but here the part, whatever the portion is there from left and right, both are same regions. But here it's not bisecting. It is only perpendicular. The lines are perpendicular. They're not bisecting.
Okay, ma'am.
Understand the point, ma?
Yes, ma'am.
Right. Diagonals are equal and bisect each other. You can write each angle is 90 also. There is no need to mention, but already if you want, you can write as one more point as each angle is also 90. You can mention, no? Each interior angle is equal to 90. Each interior angle is equal to 90 degrees. in the north, but not least, children, we'll go with the last figure, the kite. What is kite shape? Do you observe what is kite shape, children?
I'm a diamond shape.
Diamond shape, yes. That means there is a difference between diamond and a kite, children. We know that. What we know that? Yes. Okay, I will draw something. There is a very, very basic point you have to remember in this, children. In this kite shape, you just observe the things. What is this, Nana? Is it happens as a kite shape?
Yes, shape? Ma'am.
Which two sides are equal and parallel here?
Ma'am, the adjacent sides.
Adjacent, very good. The adjacent sides are equal here. Adjacent sides are equal. Is this diagonals bisect each other? Bisect,
yes,
or perpendicular?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Is this diagonals bisect each other? Yes, please.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. The diagonals are perpendicular to one another. Write down, children. The diagonals are perpendicular to one another. Diagonals are perpendicular to. This is the symbol for perpendicular to one another. The diagonals are perpendicular to one another. Next, it's exactly two pairs of adjacent, yeah. With exactly two pairs of equal consecutive sides. Now, my consecutive sides means adjacent sides are equal. This side and this side should be same. And this adjacent sides are equal. How you supposed to write? There are two pairs of equal consecutive sides. Two pairs of equal consecutive sides. Consecutive means adjacent. Equal consecutive sides. Yes, Bhavya.
Ma'am, are the diagonals? Do the diagonals bisect or perpendicular?
Bhavya, we can take here, yes, the diagonals are perpendicular to one another, bisect also, ma. One of the bisect each other. You just see, bisect means whatever the region is there from this. This is equal to this part, this region is not equal to this. Well, how you supposed to write one of the diagonal bisect, not both the diagonals? Bhavya. This is, you just observe, this is suppose if I'm taking as A, B, C, D. What are the diagonals, Bhavya? If you take as AC diagonal, if you take the whatever the side, this suppose the middle point, O to A is equal to O to C, but OD is not equal to OB. OD is not equal to OB. Then what we can say here, one of the diagonal bisect, not both the diagonals, only one of the, very good point, one of the diagonal bisect in kite. Understand, okay, Bhavya?
Yes, ma'am, I understood.
One of the diagonal bisect, the other, not both the diagonals. Now, whatever we supposed to take, Nana, just think, whatever the measures of angles, opposite angles are equal, Nana. What are the opposite angles if you take? Suppose angle A is, measures of angle A is nothing but angle, measures of angle C. The same way, measures of angle D is nothing but, measures of angle D is nothing but measures of angle B. These are the very important, it's not equal. Only one pair of angles are equal. Which pair? It is not equal, I think. These two are not equal. One pair of opposite angles are also equal here. Why? Because one diagonal bisect each other. That's why only one pair of angles are equal. Now, another pair is not equal.
Ma'am?
Yes. Yes, ma'am.
But D and B are equal, right, ma'am?
D and B are equal. One pair, anything. If you take, which angle is happening here? You just see here, children. We are just taking as a yeah, right, ma. Here in this case, these are not equal. This is equal, right? Right, right. Good. Opposite, which one is equal here? These are not equal. This is equal. Right, Nana. I will just make another color with this. Angle D and angle measures of angle D and angle B are equal, not this other angles A and C. Right. These are the different points about kite children. Kite means what you have to think only one diagonal bisect each other. The diagonals are perpendicular to one another. There is a two pairs of consecutive sides are equal. Consecutive sides are equal. And one pair of opposite angles are also equal, not another one pair of opposite angles. So which pair means angle B and angle D are equal, not angle A and angle C. Yes, children, now these are the different points. Based on this, we have some more bits in this textbook. We will go through that questions, children. Very beautiful questions, very simple, children. Yes, till now we discussed many points. Not only that, we have many application part about the diagonals of the parallelograms and rhombus square, rectangle too. Shall we go with some based on properties? We will go with a few questions, children. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Now let me take with the property diagonals of parallelogram bisect each other. With that property, I'm going to do a few more questions in the exercise 3.3, page number. If you have textbook with you, open your textbook page number 51, Nana. Open your page number textbook 51, exercise 3.3. In this question is given as, consider the following parallelogram. Find the values of unknown x, y, z. You have to find out. There is a parallelogram is given. We know that our properties of parallelogram. Parallel sides, opposite sides are parallel and equal. Opposite sides are parallel and equal. What other points we can take here, Nana? Sum of, so this is a quadrilateral. Sum of angles in the quadrilateral should be equal to 360. And the other sides are given as x, y, z. How are you supposed to find out these all values? Yes, we know that the properties of parallelogram. What property you know, children? What property you know?
All sides.
Yes, what property we know that here to find out the values of x, y, z?
Ma'am, opposite angles are equal.
Very good, very good. First, just now you go with your parallelogram. Opposite angles are equal. Based on, since from opposite angles are equal property, opposite angles are equal. Very good. So here angle Y is equal to what angle, which is nothing but?
100, ma'am.
This is 100, yes. Now Z and X both are equal. According to Z and X both are equal. We know that a sum of angles in a quadrilateral should be equal to X plus Y plus Z plus 100 equal to how much? And the sum of angles in a quadrilateral should be equal to
360.
But we know that Y is 100. We know that, and both this X and Z are both are same. So suppose if both are same, means I'm taking as X only. Why? Because this is anyway 100. Z is nothing but X. So we can substitute as Z as X, 360. Now these two angles together, 2x, 2x plus 200 equal to 360. Here 2x is nothing but if you transpose other side, it becomes 360 minus 200. So 2x is how much, Nana? 100 and? Yes, how much?
160, ma'am.
Yes, 160. So x value is 80. So if you, X value is 80 means you know that both are equal, opposite. This is equal, this one. By seeing only you can share, children, 200, this opposite sides are 200. Rest of 360 minus 200 means 160. 160 angle should be shared for both the angles. No need of doing in the competitive examinations, you can do directly. If any written part is given subjective paper, you have to do, or else you can go with directly. 160 angle shared by equally shared means you have to 80 80 z and x. Therefore you have to write what is the values of x, y, z you are getting. What are the values you are getting, Nana? X, y, z values.
180 and 80, ma'am.
That's all. Manideep, in the same way, we have other question. Very, very similar questions. Any doubt in this? Any doubt in this, ma'am?
No, ma'am.
No. Okay. Now, the same way, there is another parallelogram is given. Very simple parallelogram. But here exterior angle is given as Z, Nana. There is no interior. Interiors are given. What are the interiors given? Let me write on the screen. So this angle is X. Obviously, we don't know this angle is opposite angle to X is Y is given. Another angle is given as 50, Nana. If this angle is 50, means obviously this means how much, children?
50, ma'am.
So 180 minus 50 will get...
So this is 100 is over. 100 is over means this two together shared. So 260 shared by two angles. 130. Right, Nana?
Ma'am, X is also 130.
Yeah, X is 130, Y is 130, even Z is also 130. Why? Because linear pair. Z plus 50 is linear pair, Nana. Z plus 50 is 180. Why? Because it is a linear pair. Linear pair means a straight angle, right, Nana? So then yes, linear pair. This is a straight line angle. Straight angle means these two together it is 180. So you have to Z value as 180 minus 50. It's nothing but 130. So angle Z is 130. Same way you have to find Y and X are both are opposite angles, both are equal. Why? Because this is already opposite on another pair of opposite as the sum of other pair of opposites as 100. So 100, if you remove from 360, you will get 260. 260 should be shared for both angles, means angle X is, or else if ma'am, I don't know anything about, means you just go with a procedure. X plus Y plus 50 plus 50 is 360. And then you have to substitute X, Y, both are same. Why? Because opposite angles, X and Y is X equal to Y. Therefore, X plus 100 is equal to 360. I know only 2X is nothing but 360 minus 100. We can take a 2X is nothing but 260. X is nothing but 130. X is nothing but 130, half of 260. So that X is nothing but Y means Y is also 130. You can just do like that. X value 130, Y value 130, Z value 130. Yes. Any doubt, children, in this?
Yes. No, ma'am.
Shall I give a few bits for you practice? Can you do right now?
Okay, ma'am.
Nothing more, children. There is another question. Sorry.
Ma'am, actually, I'll see the recording and I'll try bits from tomorrow, ma'am.
Okay, please do that, Harshita, because you are a little busy. You are unable to join the class, one or two classes, so that it is lagging. But it is very simple, Vedika. Sorry.
Yes, ma'am.
There is, what is this, Nana? What is the diagram is given? You just observe. This is the figure given. In this, the angles are given as right angle. Yes, this is 90 degrees is given. This is X is given. This angle is given as Y. This angle is given as 30 degrees. And this is given as Z. This is given as Z. Now you are supposed to see, children, what you have to find out, the values of X, Y, Z you have to find out. How you supposed to find out the values of X, Y, Z, children? We can go with the opposite in X is nothing but 90 directly. Can we go with X is nothing but 90? Why? Yes. Can we take it as x equal to 90 children here? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
So why we can take it as x equal to 90? Please let me know.
Ma'am, because z is equal to 90 and x is the opposite angle, so it will be equal to...
Very good. X and z are both are opposite to each.
Yes, ma'am. Vertically opposite angle.
Yes. Vertically, VOA. Vertically opposite angles are equal. Vertically opposite angles are equal. So x equal to 90, children. So once x value is 90, you know one another angle in this triangle is 30. 90 plus 30, how much, Nana? 120. 120 plus what number gives you? 180. X plus 30 plus 120, y is nothing but 180. X value you are getting as 90. 90 plus 30 plus y is 180. Y is nothing but 180 minus 120. Its y value as 60. Y value as 60. Go through the rest of the questions too, children. There are a few more bits are there. And draw the questions. Is there any doubt in this question, children? By seeing only, you can answer this. VOA means vertically opposite angles are equal. Let me draw another question here. This is also given like a parallelogram. This parallelogram. Value is Z. This is 80. This is given as X. This is given as Y.
Ma'am, Z and Y are 80.
Y equal to directly, can you say y is nothing but 80, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Y, but opposite angles, both are parallelogram, opposite angles are equal. Y, Bhavya.
Ma'am, could you help me solve z in the previous question, ma'am? Later?
Oh, sorry, we didn't complete z. Okay. Z in the previous question directly given as, okay, this is another angle, right. One is 90, Bhavya. So here one angle is 90 means we can take this is what type of if you take as same sides and no, vertically opposite angles also not happen. What property we can use children to find out the value of z here? We didn't find z value, right. What property we can use here? Z plus 90 plus. Can we take it as any other things here? No, this is
30 degrees because it's there in the previous one.
How you will take as a 30? No, we don't know this angle, right?
Yes, ma'am.
This is 30 means you can take this as 30, right? Right.
Some alternate interior.
Yes, alternative interiors. You can take as 30, right? This is 30 means 30 should be, one is Z plus 90 plus 30 is nothing but 180. So that 90 it is already there. So what is the rest of the angle here? That is 180 minus 120. It's a 60. Z value is 60, Bhavya, here. Right. I forgot about this point. So how you supposed to write, how you supposed to write this? What is the property you are using to find the value of z here?
Alternate interior angles.
Very good. The alternative interior angles are equal. You have to mention that point also, children. Alternative interior, since from alternative interior angles are equal, so that we can write it as in the triangle other angle is 30. You can write here, alternative interior angles are equal. Here you're supposed to write this point. Alternative interior angles are equal. yesterday. Okay, this week how you suppose this is very simple, children. You can go with opposite angles are equal. If this is x means x plus z is 180. X plus z is 180. How you supposed to find x value? This is 80 plus 80 means 160. If 360 means 160 means x is 100. Y, this angle is also 100. 100 plus z is nothing but 180. Z equal to 80. This we can use another property also, Nama. Same side of interior. Z equal to, any doubt in this? How I supposed to do this, which? Any doubt, please let me know. In the last diagram. So then in the last diagram, first you have to find out the value of y, so that y is V80, y because opposite angles are equal in parallelogram. Once you know the two angles are equal, opposite other two angles are equal. So 80, 60, 160 you have to subtract from 360, you will get 200. 200 should be shared by both the angles since both are equal opposite angles. So 100, x value is 100. But you know z and x is a linear pair. So z value, if you want to find out, already 100 as x value, other angle. So what other extra part? 80. It is z is 80. This is the way we can find x, y, z. That's any doubt in this?
No, ma'am.
Next. This is very simple, children. Go other bit. There is another question in your textbook. But you have to write the reason to, children. Write the reasons to solve the questions.
Okay, ma'am.
Reasons everywhere you have to mention the reason why I am taking this. No objective part we are not going to test. Any subjective pattern is happening. Here the question is given as one diagonal is given. This angle is 40 given. This angle is given as Z. This is given as Y. This is given as 112. This is given as X. This is given as X. Yeah, you need to find out X, Y, Z. Who will give answer here, children? X value, Y value, Z value, how we supposed to find it? Yes, can we take it as 112 equal to Y, children? Y is nothing but 112. Yes or no? Can we take it as y is 112, opposite angles are equal in the parallelogram? Yes, children. Then what we can write 112 is, so y value is 112, this rest of the angle is how much? Z plus 40 is nothing but x plus another angle you're supposed to take. But both should be equal, these two should be equal. How these two should be equal? We can equate 112 two times. You have to take, children, 200 or 224. If you subtract 224 minus 360, what angle you will get? It's 5 minus 2 is 3. It's 136. 136 should be shared by both. So z plus 40 is 136 by 2. Half of 136, how much, Nana? How much? 136 by 2. 68. Now z is equal to 68 minus 40. So z is equal to 20. So z value is 28. So what is the x value? Directly you can write, so the x value is also. Yes, x value, how much, children, in this case?
Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
X is equal to 28.
X equal to 28, right. Very good. Directly you can say that. Or else if you don't know how to do also, this 28 plus 112, you have to combine. Nana. This is 8, 120, 140. Rest of the angle is 40. 40 plus what angle makes you? 40 plus what angle makes you 68? It is 28. So x is also 28. Or else directly you can write x and z both are alternative interior angles, so that both are equal. You can write it as directly x is nothing but 28. Any property, it should be related to your property. Okay, children, shall we end up today's session so that we can meet in the next class? Please go through the other bits too. If you have any doubts, please let me know, children. The rest, there are a few more questions you have. Please practice those bits too. Yes, children, shall I end up today's session? Any doubt in today's class, children?
No, ma'am.
Okay, please go through the other. There are few more bits. The diagrams are given. Please go through that. And what is given in the, there is a parallelogram only given. So parallelogram, the opposite, diagonals bisect each other. Based on that, you have one property. And parallelogram, opposite sides are equal. Based on one property is there. If you want, we can discuss those bits more 5 minutes. I will give diagrams in just a minute, children. I'll give diagrams and I'll help you so that you can practice in home also. I'll draw the diagrams. The diagrams are given. Other diagrams are given as there is a parallelogram given. Parallelogram is given. So in this parallelogram, 3y is nothing but 3y is nothing but 3y minus 1 is nothing but 26. Here it is given as 3x equal to 18. You need to find x and y values. What you should do, children, opposite sides are equal. Nana. So 3y minus 1 equal to 26. 3x is 18. You have to solve these equations to find out the values of x and y. This is one method. Another method is given as, another question is given as, there is a parallelogram is given. Diagonals are given for the parallelogram. We know that the diagonals are bisect each other in parallelogram. You know that the diagonals bisect each other. So that this is given as x plus 16, this portion. X plus y, not 16. X plus y is given. Another portion is given as 16. In the above diagonal, it is given as 20. This portion is given as 20. This is given as y plus 7. You just make equate both the things. Y plus 7 is 20. Here x plus y is 16. Please, whatever the y value you are getting, you substitute in this, you will get x value. Why we are equating here in parallelogram, all sides are equal, parallel sides are equal, and diagonals bisect each other. Diagonals bisect each other. Next, another question is, I'm not doing, children, please do it your own. You can think at least some part. All the bits I'm doing means you are unable to think anything. So you can draw, there is a diagonal given, 40 angle is given for this. And the other angle is given, this is exterior given as 70 degrees. And your y value given, interior, one interior is given. The opposite side is x is given. So that you have to find out the values of x, y, z. This is given as z. Can you find out the z, x, y, z values? How you supposed to find out, children? How you supposed to find out? Can we take as y value 40y? Directly y is nothing but 40y. Bhavya?
Yes, ma'am.
Y? And this angle, if you want this angle, you can subtract 180 minus 70. 180 minus 70, how much, Nana?
110.
110. So 110, these opposite angles are equal. X is also 110, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Opposite angles are equal. Now only one part you are supposed to find out. What is the Z value?
Z
value. Y value also, this is, you know that 40. Now, in a triangle, you just take this as a triangle. 110 plus 40, 150. Z is 30 degrees. Z is 30 degrees. How means the sum of angles in a triangle should be equal to 180 degrees? Based on that, you know that the rest of the two angles together 150, you have to find out the value of z, means z is 30. That's all. This is another question. There is one more interesting question. There are two parallelograms cutted each other. It's really interesting question, children, this ninth bit. Please, I will draw the picture on the screen. Please try it. Tomorrow we'll discuss this. By seeing, you can get it as a trapezium, but the parallelogram only. Actually, there are two parallelograms. They're cutting like that. This is taken like that, one diagram. Another diagram, these parallel sides are taken, if it is taken. If you consider as two parallelograms, this is one parallelogram. This complete is another parallelogram. This angle is given as x none. This angle is given as x. So how you supposed to find out the values of 120, then 70. You need to find the value of x. So who will find out the value of x here, children? Yes, who will find out the value of x here? How are we supposed to find out the value of x over here? Children, this is a quite interesting question. Please try to think. There are two parallelograms are there. The two parallelograms. Find the value of x. How are you supposed to, please think about this question, children. How are you supposed to find the value of x? We know that, children, that this angle is 120. Opposite of this is also 120. These two shade equally 240. 360 minus 240 means how much, Nana? 360 minus 240 means how much? Children, 360 minus 240.
120.
120 should be shared both. 120 should be shared both means 60. This side, opposite side, this is a 60. Now you have to know this is 70. This opposite side is also what happens, Nana? 70. This 60, this 70, you know that sum of angles in a triangle should be equal to 180. 120, 130 plus what number gives you? 130 plus what number gives you? Yes, x plus 60 plus 70 is nothing but 180. So x plus 130 is 180. X is nothing but 180 minus 130. 180 minus 30. 130, how much? It's 50 degrees. X value 50. Is nothing but 50. So then any doubt here, how I supposed to get?
No, ma'am.
Any doubt, please raise your hand. I can repeat the thought. Why? Because there are two quadrilaterals, children, opposite angles are equal. So 120, 120 shade, the rest of the angle is 60, 60. So that the triangle, whatever the triangle you want to find out x value, in that you know one of the angle is 60. So other parallelogram, they gave already opposite, one side is, one angle is 70, opposite to other angle is also 70. So one more angle you will get in the triangle. You need to find out the value of other angle x. X plus 60 plus 70 is together at 180, x is 50. That's all, children. You can go. There are 10th bit is your homework today. Please complete 10th bit and come back with your answers. Then we'll discuss few more points are there in the regarding to that rectangle, how it is based on that rectangle properties and other quadrilateral property. We can go with one or two bits so that our topics will be completed. More need one more class so to complete this understanding elementary shapes. Any doubts in today's session? Children, please let me know. Any doubts?